Salute, salute. Check it out, check it out. I'm wearing my Beyond Fitness mask. Beyond Fitness is our brand and lifestyle platform. You know what I'm saying? Me and some close friends of mine, essentially like brothers. Beyond Fitness is what we promote. Like I said, it's a brand. We have everything from masks to shirts. We're making full sweatsuits. Whatever it is your imagination can conjure up, if letters and wording can go on it, then we can put our logo on it and get you right. So absolutely, man, look into the Beyond Fitness. Hit me up. Find out about the Beyond Fitness. Without further ado, right? Salute, General Hiro Musa Etiquette. I'm affectionately referred to as General Etiquette, and I've been thinking, right? So I wanted to do my due diligence as a New Yorker, as a hip-hop fan, as an artist who has music out myself, as a co-label owner, right? As someone who is engulfed and respects and grew up on the culture, the hip-hop culture, because we know it with the black community and hip-hop culture have always been intimately tied together. And many people could argue that hip-hop has always been a window into our community or a reflection of the current state of affairs in our community, for better or for worse, right? So the reason I wanted to make this video, I wanted to salute, shout out, and send my blessings to a legend, DMX. Now, for anybody from New York, from anybody who loves hip hop, for anybody who's been around in the past 20 years, right? It's been a while since DMX really was in the forefront of the hip hop industry, but he has been a major and a central figure. DMX is one of the biggest superstars, right, our culture has ever seen. His music categorically changed the sound of hip hop, right? There were few people. A lot of people were able to come into the business and become successful, but there were few people that was able to take a pre-existing system, remix it down with their own unique sound and voice and the rawness and the realness, and produce a lot of the major hits that we still listen to this day. As I understand it, DMX had a run-in with drugs, and DMX is in critical condition. And the truth of the matter is whilst I'm not a doctor and or an expert, I don't know, right? It doesn't sound like this is something that passes easily and will be easy to recover from. What I do send is my blessings to his family. What I do send is love and prayers to him and his family. DMX, you are one of the biggest figures our culture has ever seen. We've taken a lot of L's this year, and the truth of the matter is that we need you to pull through. The culture needs you to pull through. Your family needs you to pull through. Everybody who loves you needs you to pull through, right? Like I said, we took a lot of L's this year. DMX, as a New Yorker, as a hip-hop fan, I had to do my due diligence and send my blessings out there and tell everybody, please, pray for DMX. Send love his way. Like I said, we've taken a lot of L's in the culture as of late. We're taking L's as a species with the pandemic and everything that's going on. We just been taking a lot of L's, right? In times like this, one, it goes to show us that moderation is difficult when you're abusing substances, right? It goes to show us that acquiring fame, fortune, and success isn't the end all be all, because we've seen too many examples of people pursue money endlessly, attain that, realize that that's all they ever worked for and or wanted to do, and now they're lost, right? Then we see binges on drugs and or potential suicide. Why? Because people aren't battling the demons that they have within them. Social capital does not make you impervious. Social and financial capital does not make you impervious to the realities of emotion, the realities of circumstance. Now, whilst it can help be a tool to shift and change your circumstances, it doesn't make you impervious to laws. It does not make you untouchable. And a lot of times we see the downfall of incredible figures, incredible artists, all because, right, they didn't look themselves in the mirror or along their journey. They weren't valuing self-love. They weren't valuing tackling a lot of the things that have stopped them and hindered them along their journey. So we see countless, countless examples of hip-hop icons. We see countless examples of people in our community imploding, right? People abroad, beyond the community, right? Imploding. So please, if there's any silver lining that can be taken from this, let it be as a cautionary tale to all the young people coming up and all the people of age right now. Understand that if you don't deal with and tackle the issues you have, if you don't seriously try to address your trauma, if you continue to brush it off, right, in the relentless pursuit of money, one day you may attain said resources. You may attain all the luxury and grandeur life has to offer. But then you'll be left with all that you've acquired, no healing, and all the pain. So salute. Shout out to and blessings to DMX. And I hope this isn't the beginning of us saying goodbye. What I do hope is that we look at these examples. We see how our community has been impacted. We see what's going on. And we take legitimate steps to start to remedy a lot of these ailments, a lot of the things plaguing our communities. We have to do better. We have to try something different. We have to maneuver.